when these lawmakers were there, when this lawmaker happened to be there, so they were not also considering the part putting something, these sports of betting and gambling in constitution.
Okay.
And it was something in the 2nd September, the assembly meeting 1949-56. There were certain people like when there was some professor, very famous professor work on this constitution, like Professor Shivan Lal, then Sri Lakshmi Narayan, right, and Professor Saxena. They were in the belief that putting gambling, betting in sports was something against the moral issue. Because yeah. Gandhiji itself given the example that you cannot, like there was a few like Gandhi principle, right? Gandhi principle, if you say like they are not in the support of putting this gambling, betting in constitution. But for them, like you have already got the example of Mahabharata. What happened, Mahabharata, how people have came out from this properties and all. So there was something for them, there's something different. You're getting my point. But there is only one person whose view was something different. Right. And reason for that, it was they are now part in the 34th entry of 7th schedule. Right, entry 34, 2nd list 2. So whose view is that? That was in the view on the state list. It was the view of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He was in the different prospect. He was in the view. You are saying that, okay, being a Gandhi thought, you are saying that now we will not put something, the bad omen thing, like gambling and betting in the constitution. Forget about the articles with the entries. So if you put that as a omen thing, that will create a huge problem. But Ambedkar, sir, view was something like, Sir Ambedkar was something like, if you are not putting something at least for a straight entry, then like if someone start that, then how can we prohibit them? How can we stop them? Like it have to be put somewhere. So that is the reason nowadays you can find in 34-2, you can find that. So this is something we need to keep in mind. So this was the starting for the beginning itself. We haven't thought now, we haven't taken sports as seriously, whether in the studies
or even
whether in the laws. Right. So now this is the reason, like Mizoram, recently Mizoram came up with a new act of this betting act and all. So you can see the different state nowadays having a different rules. Right. Rajasthan court saying no, you have to ban. Punjab is saying no, you can. See, now coming to another prospect, which is like, no. The fantasy league, Dream 11, now it is getting very highlight after the Rajasthan and Punjab thing, right? So you could think on that fine. This context, I will take a reference for that case of very famous case of Andhra State of Andhra Pradesh. You never, I think you were from Karnataka, right?
Yes.
Your neighboring state of Andhra Pradesh, and versus K. Satyanarayan, very famous case of 1968, and that. In what happened in this case, there was a question for something regarding betting and gambling. Like whether you put Romy as a betting or as a gambling. Right. So now if you say betting and gambling, so there is a very thin line difference in that. What is the difference? It's something we say game of skill versus game of chance. Right. Skill and chance is two proper objects which we need to see through. Right, I am using the term see through properly. Because why I'm saying that? Because wherever there is a skill, we see this betting and betting somewhere. We cannot find some company which is saying like gambling 365. You will find betting 365 because somewhere betting is legal. Right? Well, gambling is illegal. But people get confused on that. Now Dream 11. Like Joel, you were also starting before the betting, also we talked about the Dream 11, right?
Yeah.
The Supreme Court says Dream 11 is a fantasy. Right. So now fantasy league is also different from betting. See, fantasy league means like, see, if you take esports as a domain, which is also a new field. So I will ask people not to go for sports. I will say go for esports domain. Because esports is a domain which is esports domain, right?
But what is the available infrastructure there in India as such with regard to esports?
Yes, Mr. Lokesh Uji is the president of Esports Federation of India.
Okay.
We have Esports Federation.
Okay.
Right? And even I think by next Olympic, esports will be the game. I mean, esports will be another sports which you will find in Olympic. We have International Esports Federation also. We have VESA also. VESA is referring the UK. That was the oldest one, but now it's not in the form. Now we support for the Esports Federation, International Esports Federation, which is another form. So, but now, so it's also as it's in developing phase. So people see, I have to talk anything. See, we thought that just something around 40 minutes, but it's going on 1 hour after hour, right?
Yeah, because.
Sure. We have to. Why I'm saying this one? Because you know, the esports in developing many prospects. So first of all, coming to the esports, you are playing a mobile game,
okay. Right?
I think you all guys play PUBG. We'll not say PUBG now. We'll say Battleground India. Right? The name has changed now, right?
Yeah.
So Battleground India, you are playing same thing PUBG and all, because so it's better to understand the highlighting as a PUBG, right? So yeah. When you're playing PUBG in a mobile. Right, that is you are playing for recreation. That's a recreation game. Right, same game when you are playing with a modem, like someone organized that game in a certain platform. Right, lots of people are there. You have a team, you are sitting in front with versus X versus Y. You are today with Tiger, Team Tiger. I am today versus Team Ryan. Maybe somewhere like maybe Ryan is there with Team Lion. And someone is sponsoring you that game, like an organization, the Olympia is sponsoring that game. The same game then change into esports. You're getting the difference between this.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? So this is now coming to the fantasy league. To for the fantasy league. The fantasy league is something like that is fully a game of skill. How you are creating a team. In Dream Eleven, for example, you are creating a team. What's the example? It's real fact. You create a team. How you create that team? You create that team on the basis of the player's skill, not on the basis of their luck. Luck factor is not there. That's not the basis of the chance. That is skill. Right? And how we are choosing that today? Okay, Varun Chakravarti had taken 4 wickets in this match. Today, 2 matches before, he has taken 3 wickets. Means he is in form. He will be taking wicket something 3 wickets. Okay, Virat Kohli scored 0 in the previous match. Next, 2 match before this match again, he's out in 1. It means I will not take Virat Kohli because he's out of 4. Right? Prithvi Shaw scored 86, 56, 72. Now, when you're creating the team, you will say, like, okay, I will say Prithvi Shaw is in form and there is a chance he will create a score. This is how you're creating a fantasy team. Right, this is not an original team, you're taking a fantasy team. So it's on the mayor of yours, their skill, you are deciding that. So this is game of skill. It's not a gamble, it's betting. Right. Now coming to the esports. So I complete this phase now. Just put it in the side.
Like towards that point, sir, I think there are some questions which are pertaining with regard to the topic at hand. I think Atul had a similar kind of question. If Atul could just raise his question with regard to the topic.
Yeah, sir, because you know, esports is something which is developing in India. So could you just tell me about those, what can I say about those things? You know, the main legal issues that esports player is facing, like the contracts and common clause or maybe potential legal issues, you know, all sorts of things that a player, you know, as a single person, what problems is he facing in India, sir?
So the single person, say after development of this Indian esports federation, will not face this type of problem further, right? After creating this federation, because even if you play Atul, you can go. And the reason is that we don't get advertisement of this same thing. The problem is basic structure advertisement. In UK, I mean, not say the UK, in US, take an example of US. You know how this people develop there from our university level. That is fully dependent on the university. They have to develop that player. Mostly, you will see the athletics in the US. They came from this university itself, right? But when we come into India, if you are a student, for example, Atul, if you are an esports player, I know there is like Zuel or Ryan. They are like somewhere. They are the basketball player, right? But for them, until national level, what the next? Right. But if you say in US, that is totally different. Now, your question, like, what is the problem? Yeah, there was a certain problem in going through, which was in esports federation. Not only that, that was also same thing happened with our ISL also, regarding the contract of these players. So now when for coming, let first go to traditional sports, then I'll come to the esports and new domain, Atul, your question. So what happened to that in East, this ISL and all, when ISL started, it was a closed league, it was not open league. You're getting my point, like closed league and open league, the relegation system was not in ISL. So that's the reason we see it's a closed league, not the open league. Whenever there is like in Premier League, the English league, we have seen the people really, clubs relegate from one place to another. So this is, we say something, open system. Right, and in India, people used to contract on the basis of Indian Contract Act, whether there is a minor person or not, the 18 things and all that was something like something we do, same thing which mentioned Indian Contract Act. And I don't think I have to give you a definition which is regarding the minor act representation and all is there in the Indian Contract Act. You guys already know that, right? The representation of the people who is under 18, the minor age,
yeah,
right? So this totally different, which is now in RSTP. RSTP says something different. They say, no, it's something I think that this Atul is under 18, that I will be representing Atul, right? Which says in the Indian Contract Act. The RSTP says until you are in the proper age, you were in not proper way to go for the transfer, right? Forget transfer of player, forget about this Mr. Bossman rule, Joe's Bossman rule, forget that. You, until you are going to the certain age, you have to be in that, you have to play for that club itself. Well, that is the reason today if someone is playing for Barcelona B, until the major age goes, they does not go for the other clubs, right?
Yes.
Now, it is something traditional sports was. In traditional sports, we also have the issue of doping, right? Then yes, which is now in developing, you know, there's the funniest fact why is developing. Like people are asking me, why sir, you're saying it's already developed. Recently they came out 2021, this WADA came out with a list of prohibition list of like the medicine which we not to be taking and all. People say normal, people say doping means taking drugs, but I said doping means enhancing your performance. Why is that? I will come into the part. So when I say the enhancing of the performance is totally different thing, right? Today Joel won the gold medal, so he's enhancing his performance just like Armstrong. Right. So the subject is something different thing. Now, why is that problem? Because there was a case, I found a person named in Winter Olympic, and he was an athlete from UK. Right. What happened? He has a habit to take in a Vicks inhaler. Right. So he took that Vicks inhaler from, he bought it from US. Okay. And just before the match, he inhaled that. Just a vapor of the Vicks inhaler. Just think on that. Just a vapor of Vicks inhaler. He inhaled that. Next day when he got his bronch, he won the bronch. When people took his sample, they found a sample of certain drugs in his in his sample, right? The sample A and both in sample A and sample B. Then they asked if they investigated and what are the things we have taken and all. So then he was also in shock. I haven't taken anything. Then how is it in your body if you haven't taken anything? So after long process, they came to know that he has a habit to take Vicks inhale, the vapor. So when he took the Vicks inhale, it happened that the US product of Vicks inhale is different from the Vicks UK product of Vicks inhale. The certain sample which they use in US is in the prohibition list of WADA, which is not in the prohibition, like which is will not find in the UK.
Okay.
Not only that, sometimes there's like very another funny incident happened. Like I will not take the player name here. So it happened that he was in the club, right? Friday night weekend, he was in the club and he kissed a girl. Next day he went for a match and his sample, they found out that sample A and then sample B both found out that was doping. And he was also in shock. Like, I haven't taken anything. Yeah, I was at the party and I haven't seen anything. I haven't taken anything other than spirit at all. So how this happened? Then, but he got secure. He got in a proper platform. Like, he was safe. Why he was safe? Because the girl who used, he came in that face that, you know, like I was in this, like, I was taking drugs. I have taken cocaine, not him. When I kissed him, suddenly, but for my body, his body. Right. So when I will say now, like Now it's coming to the Atul question. YMC is developing. So contract and all, if you go for ISF, they already have work on this contract pattern. We already found the competition policies and all, which type of gadget you will use and all. It's already there. Traditional doping thing is already there, right? But the thing which is not there is something different. That is the e-doping phase. Right now, if I say e-doping, yes, what do you understand the terms of e-doping?
Yeah, so you're
like,
trying to
I
say
have
that,
written a paper on this,
so like we have not yet developed in the phase of e-doping. That's what you're trying to say, sir.
Right. So e-doping and traditional doping in e-sport is totally different. E-doping means electronics, the mode of electronics. See, what is doping? I just now mentioned, right? Electro-doping means doping is something like that is to enhancing your performance, right? Whether you can use by using certain drugs or certain supplements, right? Or whether you can now in e-sports, you can use that by using certain software, glitching and boxing, you know, XYZ and aim bots and all, which you normally find out. But if you see, like if you go through the proper legislation, right, e-sports federation, you will not find something which is mentioned regarding the e-doping phase. Mostly thing which you'll find is the traditional doping. So people are still now like, you know, like certain cases we have seen in e-sports competition also, right? Like people are playing, some people player are getting banned from this, what is that very famous game, Fortnite, right? Next day he's coming back again with a new ID, right? That is also, we'll say that is also glitching in the system. We are using, some of your friend also use aim bots, trigger bots or aim bots in the game. That is a type of e-doping. Just keep in mind, doping means you are just enhancing your performance, right? You are putting certain type of coach malware function in there. What is this coach malware function? This is something like your coach will be the one when you are playing the game. Atul, for example, you are playing and say someone XYZ is your coach, and he can, after you put in the malware function in your laptop, right? And then that will be going to the main server. From that main server, going to the opposition player. And what happening that? So the coach of your team can see the position of that opposition player, where is he hiding. And mostly we have seen, we all play PUBG, right? Mostly. So when we all play PUBG, we have seen that sometimes a bullet come from somewhere we don't know. After we die, then we see that person was sitting there. So when this malware, coach malware function is there, the coach can easily detect where this opposition player is, and he can help you on that. That this is something like, this is one example giving you. There are other many big examples out there, right? After the import is very big example of that. Automatically, when player coming to in between a trigger code zone of you, then he automatically he will be dying. So this is some of the rules we need to develop on. Yeah, but now coming to this fact, UK, US's colleges are much more about the e-sports domain, and they are now developing the e-sports. Now this very, very funny fact of this fact, like e-sports domain, I mean, the development is, they are developing as a player also, they are developing as a subject also. They are giving you the course on basis of only e-sports law.
Okay.
Right? Not sports law. E-sports law. E-sports management, totally different aspect.
This current episode, the full length, will be available on YouTube. And also, you will be able to find that latest updates about the session as well on Instagram and other platforms as well. So do like, share and subscribe to our channel on YouTube. And also follow our Instagram page with regard to regular updates as well.